Welcome to Jogo Coaching. In this video, I am going to explain about capacity planning in Agile Scrum project. The topics discussed in these videos are: what is capacity planning in Agile? Why should we do the capacity planning? Or the benefits of capacity planning? How to do the capacity planning? Example of capacity planning and sample Excel template that can be used for capacity planning. Please watch the full video to know the steps to get the Excel template in email. First, let us understand what is capacity planning. The definition of capacity planning is available bandwidth or productive hours by the team to deliver the product. The productive hours is the number of hours the team members could spend to do the actual work in the project. The actual hours will be calculated after deducting the hours planned for the sprint events or ceremonies. For example, if the team members work for 8 hours per day, around 6 hours will be considered as a productive hours. Remaining 2 hours will be used for sprint events, internal discussions, etc. Availability will be measured in hours. Capacity planning will be done for all the team members for the entire sprint. Next, let's see why should we do the capacity planning. Capacity planning is needed for the teams to understand the available bandwidth for the teams to commit and complete the user stories. This will help the team to do a better planning and task allocation of sprint goal. Capacity planning gives a better visibility about the team members' availability to the product owner. Capacity planning will also help to avoid the task overload or frustration. Capacity planning will be used to plan the sprint goal effectively and provide the realistic commitment for the sprint. Now let me explain how to do the capacity planning. Team should consider 6 key points to do the capacity planning. The first one is number of team members in the Agile team. The second one is length of the sprint or iteration, that can be 2 weeks or 3 weeks or 4 weeks iteration. The third point is any holidays coming in the sprint and any leaves planned by the team members. The fourth important things we need to consider is standard working hours per day for the team members. The fifth important thing is hours needed for the sprint ceremonies or meetings. The sixth one is team members allocation for the project. That can be 25%, 50% or 100%. Let me explain the technique to do the capacity planning with an example in the next slide. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notification about new videos. You can see an example for the capacity planning Excel template in this slide. As per this example, the sprint duration is 3 weeks for the team. That is mentioned as week 1, week 2, week 3 in the top row. 15 working days are considered for 3-week sprint by excluding Saturdays and Sundays. That means working days are considered from Monday to Friday only. The second column has the team members' name, Joe, Kumar, Raghu, etc. Standard working duration is 8 hours per day, that is mentioned in the third row. Vacations taken by the team members are highlighted in red. Total of 4 days vacation planned by the team as per this example. For the vacation days, 0 hours considered for the work. First Thursday is a holiday for all the team members. You can see the gray highlights in the first week. The work hours for that day is 0. Out of 8 hours per day, 6 hours are considered for actual work, 2 hours are planned for meetings, discussions, etc. So you can see 6 hours per day for each team members. On the first day of the sprint, team will spend 4 hours for the sprint planning meeting. So the capacity is considered as 4 hours for each person on the first day of the sprint. Capacity of each team member's work is shown in the last column at the right side. For Joe, it's 82 hours. For Kumar, it's 70 hours, etc. This is the individual team member's capacity for this 3-week sprint. Total capacity of the team is calculated by adding the all team members' capacity. As per this example, the total capacity for the team is 552 hours. Hope this is clear and useful to you. Please submit your question or comments if you need further information about capacity planning. I will be happy to answer or post another video with more information. If you want the Excel template used in this video, please leave a comment for this video and send a mail to jogocoaching@gmail.com. We will send the Excel to your email address. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Be sure to subscribe and click the bell icon to get notification about new videos. Thank you.